We have discussed what is a relay. Relay is an electrically operated switch. We can classify relays according to the operation, according to the application, according to the polarization. We have different relays. We are classifying according to the operation. As we already discussed, relay is having 5 terminals. Out of those 5 terminals, we use 2 terminals for the supply, and these are 3 terminals, normally open, normally closed, and a movable contact. This arm or this pole or this mechanical contact is connected between movable contact and normally closed. When we give the supply to this relay, automatically this mechanical contact will be moving towards the normally open. We have discussed, if it is a 5 volts relay, when we are providing the 5 volt supply, that 5 volt supply is moving this mechanical contact from normally closed to the normally open. But why, if we ask the question, why this mechanical contact is moving from normally closed to the normally open? Sir, we have given 5 volt supply, that is fine. If we give the 5 volt supply, why the mechanical contact is moving? Sir, there may be chance that current is flowing through this relay. That current, because of that current, magnetic field is forming. This magnetic field is attracting this armature or mechanical contact from normally closed to the normally open. Yes, then this type of action is called as electromagnetic action. We are giving the electric supply and we are making the magnetic field to arrive here. And this magnetic field is moving this armature from normally closed to normally open. That's why this operation is called as electromagnetic operation. So if the relay, armature move or mechanical contact moves because of the electromagnetic action, then that is called as electromagnetic relay. And the second type of operation, there is an electric thermal relay, electrical thermal relay. So what is this relay? Any relay is electrically operated device. Any relay is, when we give the electric voltage, the mechanical contact should move from normally closed to normally open. Then what is the difference between this electromagnetic relay and electrothermal relay, sir? Electrothermal relay, when we provide the voltage, the temperature, whatever the temperature, because this is a thermal relay, this temperature is making the mechanical contact to move from this place to this place. That's why this is called as electrothermal relay. Here we are not using the magnetic action to move the mechanical contact. There is no doubt, finally mechanical contact only moving from normally closed to normally open. But we are asking, by which procedure? Sir, I am using the help of the magnetic field lines, then this is electromagnetic relay. Sir, I am using the temperature, then it is called as electrothermal relay. Another person comes, I am not interested in using this electrothermal and electromagnetic. I have a special mechanism, solid state mechanism. This is solid state mechanism. You will learn later. As of now, that is not part of our syllabus. So if we use the solid state mechanism to move the mechanical contact from normally closed to normally open, then that is also a relay. So according to the operation, we have classified mainly relays into 3 types: electromagnetic relay, electrothermal relay, and solid state relay. Another very intelligent or clever person comes and says, why cannot I use combination of any 2 mechanisms? Yes, you can use the combination of any 2 mechanisms. Sir, can I use electromagnetic and electrothermal? Yes, you can use. Electrothermal and solid state? Yes, you can use. Sir, can I use electromagnetic and solid state? Yes, you can use. Sir, can I use the combination of these 3? Yes. What is that relay? That relay is called as hybrid relay. Because you are using the combination of two operations, this type of relay is hybrid relay. You are using any two or three mechanisms to move this mechanical contact from normally closed to normally open. There is no doubt, whatever may be the operation, final result is same. When we give the voltage, that voltage is moving this mechanical contact from normally closed to normally open. Second, according to the operation we have classified, this is the operation. In order to move the mechanical contact, we have several operations. Now the second one is according to polarization, we are classifying. Sir, what is polarization? Plus or minus? If you can connect a battery in any way to this relay, then that is called as non-polarized relay. There is no need to mention plus and minus. If you strictly mention this is positive terminal, this is negative terminal, you have to connect the battery positive terminal to this part and a negative terminal to this part, then this is called as polarized relay. In the laboratory, we use the non-polarized relays. So according to the operation, we have classified. According to the polarization, we have classified. Now according to the application, where we are using this relay? Sir, I want to use for the home purposes. I want to use for some, in my home water tank, I want to detect, sir, after this water level, my motor should turn off automatically. Automatic, then you can use the relay for the home purposes. Sir, I am using this relay. I am making a toy, sir. This should turn off automatically when it reaches the wall. Commercial applications, that type of relays are available for very cheaper. You are using for some railways, they use the very high voltages, still we can use the relays. Industrial applications, many industries in olden days, 20 to 30 years before, they used to run a big infrastructure, they used to control the majority of the equipment by using the relay, turning on and turning off. But now these relays, majority of these relays in the industries, they are being replaced by the programmable logic controller, big industries. And we can also use them in military applications. In each applications, whenever we are using the relay, according to that application, the relay we are using, the current rating may change, the mechanism operation may change. So according to different types of applications, we can classify different types of relays. For all these applications, we do not use the same relay. Okay, according to the operation, we have classified electromagnetic, electrothermal, solid state mechanism, hybrid relay. According to polarization, polar, non-polar. Polar relay, non-polar. According to applications, home, commercial, industrial, military applications. Okay, right. These are the classifications of relays.